Hi everyone, welcome to Python learning series for network engineers. This is the sixth video on Paramiko tutorial. In this video we'll see the difference between exec command and invoke shell in Paramiko, how to use for loop for executing multiple commands from same session, and how to use function for executing commands on multiple devices. Using same code you will be able to execute commands on multiple devices. These are the two scripts which I have written in the previous video. So you can see here, I have written it using exec command and invoke shell. So here if you see, I'm using SSH key instead of password. You can see here, I'm just passing only username, and instead of password, I'm passing an encrypted private key for SSH authentication. If you want to use password, what you can do, you can just uncomment this session, and either you can hard code the password or you can prompt user for entering the password. And here for the system host key, I'm trusting the system host keys, because I already have added this router key into my trusted host list. Otherwise what you can do, you can use auto add policy. That's why I have commented and kept it. If you want to use different methods, you can use that from here. And here I'm using encrypted private key. And here if you see the SSH connection method, I'm using exec command. Let's have a look into the Paramiko documentation for exec command. So here you can see exec command method execute a command on SSH server. A new channel is opened and command is executed. If you see here, I have mentioned stdin, stdout and stderror with exec command. That means all the standard inputs will go through stdin and output I will get through stdout. This you can give any name, any variable name. This method matters. So we can see here, in the output it returns stdin, stdout and stderror for the executing command, and it returns three tuples. So that will command store here, and from there I'm printing the stdout and I'm decoding the output and I'm just printing. And here I've given a condition, if any error occurs, error will get stored into stderror.read and that will get printed here. So let's try executing this script. It is asking for the SSH key password. So you can see here, I'm getting the output. But you can see here, I'm not getting any router prompt at all. Now let's have a look into the invoke shell method. Only the SSH connection method is different in both. Rest of the script, the logic is same. You can see here. Here I'm using invoke shell method. Here I'm sending each command and output I'm storing it into the device access.receive with 65,000 bytes of data I have just given. And I'm giving a time, a delay, a wait time. So let me just reduce that time and let us try executing this. But here, if you see, you can see it is more interactive. You'll be able to see the router terminal and execute the command. Now let's see how to use a for loop for executing multiple commands. Here I have created a list of commands to execute in the device. First we'll see how to use a for loop for executing this. So I'll close this and we'll use invoke shell method. Let me just copy and paste it. Invoke shell function I'll call. Here if you want, we can remove the key pass. Let me just remove that. I have one more SSH key here. Here in the home folder. So you can see here, id_RSA, this is my default SSH key. This doesn't have any private key password, so I'll use that so that it won't prompt for password. I'll give id_RSA here. So let us try executing this. So you can see now it is not prompting for password, so that execution will be easy. Now let's try using a for loop for executing the command. So first I'll copy and paste this list of commands here. And here we don't have to execute each command. What we'll do, we'll just write a for loop here, for command in, so we'll call this cmd1, below that we need to iterate through each command, so we'll give the commands here. Okay, let's use a formatted string here. I'll give the variable here, command, and we'll put everything under this for loop. Yeah, now let us try executing the script. So you can see here, now all the commands are getting executed here. You can see here the commands, the input commands are coming in the next line. To avoid that, what you can do here, and equal to empty string, we'll try executing again. Yeah, you can see here it is more interactive than our previous method, exec command. Now let's see how to execute the same commands on multiple devices using same script. For that we need to use function. So let's define a function here. I'll give the function a name. I'll call this Cisco exec, and inside that I'll use a variable. Okay, we'll make the variables as IP and command. That is going to change for each device. So I'll give the variable as host, comma, command. And everything else will come under this function. And here when I define any device, now what I need to do, Cisco exec, and device IP or hostname I need to give. In my case, csr1.test.lab, and the command is going to be cmd1, what we defined earlier. So here in the for loop, what we need to give is, we need to give this command. I'll call this as commands. And now the variable will take, the host variable will take from this input, and the cmd1 we'll take from here. Now let's try executing it. Yeah, so now you can see it is getting executed. Now let's add another set of commands, cmd2. Below cmd1 I'll add this. You can even give another device if you have. I'll give cmd2 here. Now let me just try executing it. So you can see here, so it executed 2 times. For each execution you'll be able to see the output like this. If you want to handle one exception, I'll show one example here. Let me just give IP as 192.168.0.25. Let's try running the script. So you can see here, unable to connect to the device, and script stopped executing. Right. So to handle that, what we can do here, under this function we will call this as try, and let us put this under try, and let us give except, and we will print unable to connect to the device. So you can have more granular exceptions like authentication failed, everything. I did a video on that earlier. You can have a look into that. Let us try running this script again. So you can see here, now script is not exiting, it shows an exception message here and it continues with the next device. In the upcoming videos, we'll see how to use a CSV file for getting the configuration and all. I hope this video was helpful. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.